Hello friends, welcome to my channel Med Simply Learn. Today's video is about ROMA score, that is risk of ovarian malignancy algorithm score. So let's begin. So what is the ROMA score? ROMA stands for risk of ovarian malignancy algorithm. It is a clinical tool that combines two important biomarkers. One is CA125 and second one is HE4, along with the menopausal status of the female to estimate the chance that the ovarian mass is cancerous or not. So what are the biomarkers which are included in the calculation of this ROMA score? First biomarker is CA125, which is a glycoprotein found on the surface of cells in the ovaries, fallopian tubes and the lining of the uterus. And this CA125 is an important ovarian cancer marker, but it has low specificity. What that means is it is also increased or elevated in certain benign conditions like endometriosis, fibroids, pregnancy, etc. So the second marker which is used for calculation of this ROMA score is HE4. HE4 is a protein known as human epididymis protein 4. This protein was first isolated from the epididymis of the males, but it is also elevated in the epithelial ovarian cancer. So it is a marker of ovarian cancer also. It is more specific than CA125. So these two biomarkers, so by measuring both these biomarkers, ROMA combines the high sensitivity of CA125 with the high specificity of HE4 protein and thus improves the overall accuracy in detecting the ovarian cancer. Now let's see how the ROMA score is calculated. The first step is we measure the levels of HE4 and CA125 in the serum. Second step, apply the algorithm formula to calculate the predictive index. We have these two formulas. One is before menopause, second is after menopause. Then after calculation of this predictive index, the third step is calculating the ROMA score, which is a percentage value. And it is calculated by e raised to the power predictive index upon 1 plus e raised to the power predictive index into 100, where e is the exponential. Once we have calculated the ROMA score, how do we interpret this score? In premenopausal women, if the score is greater than 11.4%, we say it is a high risk. And if it is less than 11.4%, it is a low risk for ovarian malignancy. While in postmenopausal women, if the score is greater than 29.9%, it is considered as high risk, while if it is less than 29.9%, it is considered as a low risk. So finally, let's see the limitations of ROMA score. It is not effective for all the ovarian cancer types. Mainly it is for the epithelial ovarian cancer. It is less accurate for other varieties like mucinous cancer, germ cell cancers. Secondly, it has limited use in early detection or screening. And finally, it is not a standalone test for the diagnosis of the ovarian cancer. It requires integration with clinical evaluation and imaging like ultrasound, etc. It cannot replace the biopsy or other definitive diagnostic methods. Thank you.